raised as part of the spending review in November. The PNF fund is a £220 million programme nationally. I'm not quite sure how we'll access it as yet, but this consultation deals with some of the principles that underpin that. And that fund, exactly as the name suggests, is around tackling poor air quality, which could be through scrappage, could be through retrofit, it could be through a range of measures. So again, we've got a golden opportunity here to shape that fund before we know more about it. Just to close, the draft response, which is set out in the appendix, in summary, can be encapsulated as follows. We're reiterating a number of long-standing concerns that the Combined Authority have voiced, that the government's approach to tackling poor air quality is by a compartmentalised one. It's looking at it typically as a transport problem rather than a problem across governments. So if you look at health, if you look at education, for example, things that affect transport and demand for transport in big ways. Our view is that is underplayed. It's seen too much as a transport issue. Allied to that, very big onus exerted on local authorities, not denouncing the importance of local authorities, but it does need to be a shared approach between governments, between agencies, they have rail, Power England, and so forth. There's a big focus on the stimulus in this document, a big focus on technology, which comes to our mind at the expense of behavioural change, mode shift, some of the measures we talked about earlier, making the rail network more attractive, making the bus network more attractive, getting more people walking and cycling, particularly for short trips. We feel that these really crucial issues that have a direct benefit for air quality are underplayed. The scrappage issue is a high profile one, but the government is talking about some form of scrappage scheme potentially that people could trade in a polluting diesel vehicle and have a discount to be able to exchange it for another cleaner vehicle. The principle of that is supported, but we are highlighting in the draft response that there could be some unintended consequences. What we want to see are our attempts to encourage alternatives to the private car, walking, cycling, public transport and so forth, being thwarted by an inadvertent shift to clean congestion, if you like. So someone who's currently walking, cycling, using public transport, we don't want to encourage them but necessarily to switch to a car for short trips just because there's a financial incentive to do that. There needs to be a holistic approach to this. There are the main points, really, Chair. The deadline is tomorrow. The response is there in the appendix, and subject to any comments from members, any additions from members, which I'm happy to take on board, proposing that response gets submitted to DEFRA tomorrow. I'm happy to take any questions. Thanks for that.
Any questions or comments then, or wants to raise? Jerry, then, Bob.
Just a very quick one again. You mentioned walkers and cyclists, runners, but Keith and Colin, why are you even a lot of the main users of the Netflix out of every time you make these statements? It's just for reference purposes, you know where I'm coming from.
Well, we could propose a scrapping scheme of using free traders or something like that.
What about a free half Jew?
Well, that bring us some luck, you know.
You never know.
Good.
Thanks very much. It's just we've got the equality and diversity indications in there, as we would have. I'm not sure whether there's an explicitness that's maybe required in terms of those that are impacted the most also tend to have more effect because of their age. One particular group, and I referred to it earlier, with the prams. Prams got an ideal height for car exhaust, and the kiddies are getting them. I represent an area that's got one of the worst air quality measurements going, and it's one of those areas. So I don't know if you could just give a little bit of thought on the equality and diversity implications that they're beating them up a little bit. I'm absolutely sure you know all the groups as well, by the way, and all those that would be involved. I think if it was put forward a little bit there, but I have to make the comment, Chair, that I am very, very dissatisfied and disillusioned with this government's poor attempt. I'm sorry, Mr. general outlook for this, we're not really seeing any huge improvement on this. The agencies that are responsible for it, the environment needs to be handled in several different ways, several different examples of local areas. So I'm just making those comments to be honest.
Thanks for that, sir. And that's one of the key reasons I thought it was appropriate we brought this forward, even though it was a light item, because when you think about some of the very sort of stretchy stuff that's come out of the Paris Climate Accord, that hopefully, if all signatories adhere to it, gives us a fighting chance of doing something about climate change, then there is hope within all of this. But unfortunately, the current responses that were coming out of UK government don't go anywhere near what they need to do. So it's important that we're certainly kind of having our sort of strong comments on that. John?
Just very briefly, if I may, Chair, thank you all just to support your comments and previous colleagues. This is a hugely important agenda. Climate change issues are fundamental to the future of the planet. Currently, the situation is we are putting 36 billion tonnes of climate change gases into the atmosphere. And that is sustainable. The current level is something like 55 billion tonnes, so it clearly isn't sustainable. And the issue here is that we're already moving, I think it's moved between 0.6 and 1.4% in terms of the overall heating of the planet. Clearly it's items to do with nitrous oxide, but if you take the arguments in the round, this is a hugely important agenda item. And yes, we're doing only doing our little bit here, but it's extremely important that we make a statement, it's very, very important, that Gordon's already alluded to, and yourself, Chair, that we actually back this up by actual action. And I'm delighted this is going forward. I'm sorry it's such a tight time frame, it's going on tomorrow, but I mean, it's a hugely important agenda, and one which we need to keep our eyes on. So thank you very much for that.
That's
good. Thanks, Chair. Yeah, I agree with a lot of the comments that have been made, and I take the criticism on board, because I do think that a lot more can be done. It is a very, very vital problem that we've got, and it's only going to set to be get worse. All three of us agree with the response from this report going back to the authorities to see if we can improve the situation.
I'll just sort of finish up if there's no more comments, because I think this is really good sort of response here. I think you've done the usual excellent sort of synopsis of what we want to see. The one thing I'd sort of potentially add is I'll share your concerns about a less nuanced scrappage scheme where you can move from dirty cars just having clean, congested roads, basically. I do genuinely think we should be suggesting that potentially government could look at a public transport type scrappage scheme, so you could trade in a dirty old car and get a suitable free public transport ticket that might cover the next 3 to 5 years or something like that, because I think that would actually be, for some people, pretty attractive as well. So I do think that's a kind of idea we could throw back, and we could happily pilot that locally. Yeah, if you're looking for sort of case studies, with suitable funding, we could give suitable free trios to people in exchange for getting rid of dirty old cars.
Thanks, Jeff. If I can just very quickly come back to the points raised. Absolutely. We talk about carbon as a really valid body, but it's about nitrogen dioxide. If we're trying to move people from polluting vehicles to more sustainable alternatives, not only does that have an air quality benefit and a nitrous oxide benefit, it also has a carbon benefit. So there are mutual benefits, numerous benefits here. The comment about quality, really valid one. I'm not a runner, but I'm a tram user, so I completely support the...
Who pushes you around?